Alrighty, round one, game two. This time my opponent's chosen to draw, and I'm definitely not going to mulligan. I mean, this has got my bomb, it's got removal. Glinthawk. Like, turn three, galvanizer, turn four, play galvanizer and Glinthawk. That's probably not going to happen, but oh well. The rest of the hand is fantastic. And, yeah, this should be a beating. Oh, red, white. That's interesting. So, maybe my opponent sided into white, or maybe it was white from the start. We'll see. Very interesting. Three mana. Faravor, okay. Yeah, that doesn't excite me. Alright, definitely going to run out Hero of Bladehold, especially when there's only Faravors to stop me. I mean, especially with Arrest in my hand, it's not going to be hard to get value out of this. And we're going to leave Galvanizer back. Certainly going to put on more pressure next turn. And hey, if my opponent looks towards, you know, double blocking or whatever, won't run Bladehold into double blocking, but Galvanizer might be able to get in for some damage. Alrighty. So here, I mean, if I see a 4 drop, almost certainly just gonna snap arrest it and bash in with... Well, do I bash in with both my dudes? Because Galvanizer allows me to play Glinthawk, so, that's a tough call. Alright, he is attacking me. That helps. I will not block. Absolutely no reason to block. I mean, if my opponent's holding a burn spell, don't want to lose my hero, and I would like to get in with Galvanizer rather than trading with Faravor. Oh, Golem Foundry. Really? Really? Oh, Rebirth. Okay. This line of play is still bizarre. So, I mean, you can block my hero, but, and not take the three, but still gonna have plenty of damage coming at you. So, Galvanizer is definitely not gonna get in there, since I want to, play out this Glinthawk. So, just attack in with the hero. Bam. So, like so. Put 2/1/1 dudes in, give him +1/+0. Make sure you stack your triggers right. It's much less exciting the other way around, of course. Really? I mean... did you really... I mean, if Faravor had stayed back, I mean, there could have been some kind of triple block to take out the hero. But this is just... does not seem like good value for my opponent. Alright, definitely returning Galvanizer and replaying. And pass the turn. So still sitting in a good position. Yeah, my opponent play out, as long as he plays out one creature this turn. Yeah, that doesn't worry me. As long as there's only one creature, then Hero is gonna get in once again. I'm gonna arrest one of the creatures and bash in with a lot. Oh, okay. Burn the Impure plus Blister Stick, that'll do it. Good thing I still got Glinthawk, huh? And my opponent's down to only two cards. Alrighty, Galvanizer for Faravor. I guess? Sure. I mean, I'm not going to get much more value out of my Galvanizer. Does mean that that Goblin is now going to get in, but, what's she going to do? I'm sure I'll draw out of this mana flood eventually, because I, yeah, a few too many lands here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 out of 12 cards. Not exactly the kind of ratios you want to be seeing, but certainly the quality has been high enough. All right, an Acolyte doesn't concern me too much. So as long as I draw an actual card and not another land, Yeah, see, there you go. That's a card. Does well against all these chumps. And Glinthawk's going to keep getting in there. Peace Strider's certainly good for racing. And a 3-3 certainly seems stronger than anything I've seen out of my opponent's deck. Really, Golem Foundry. There's not that many artifacts, so... And Sun Chaser? Yeah, seems a bit haphazard here. Aiming for Metalcraft, but not really many ways to reliably get it. Alrighty, Spellbomb's gonna come out here, and I'm gonna sack it away. See if I draw something else. Alright, Slice and Twain. So, once my opponent actually does get an artifact, it is so dead. Attacking with Peace Strider... doesn't seem good. I mean, It'll just trade with Blister Stick plus Goblin or something like that. So, yeah, we'll just get in with Glinthawk. Especially since Peace Strider sitting back here will stare off all these guys. And I'm still keeping ahead in the race with my evasion. Yeah, even if I'm only getting in for one at a time. Alrighty. Certainly no reason to be thrown away Peace Strider or Arrest. I mean, I've got value. As soon as my opponent actually plays a good card, I'll so deal with it. Alrighty. Dark Steel Juggernaut. Wow. 1-1. A 1-1 indestructible. Yeah, I'm not even worried about that. I mean, I could arrest it if it gets big eventually, but doesn't seem like it's going to threaten me for a long, long time. I mean, my opponent paid 5 mana for that. Not exactly getting value out of it. Again, only getting in for 1. Yeah, which is fine. Fortunately, I got another flyer to add, so I'll be getting in for 3, so 4 turns. 4 turns we're looking at kills here. And yeah, still waiting for something to actually use my removal on. Alright, Salvage Gout can definitely return Golem Foundry. That's not a concern. It'll give me a sweet target for Slice and Twain. Although it doesn't actually do anything. I mean, I guess it pumps up Juggernaut and gets my opponent one step closer to getting Metalcraft with Sun Chaser. Yeah, getting in for 1, I'm going to block with Peace Strider. If you want to use removal on Peace Strider, that's fine by me. Alrighty. Ooh, Necrogen Sensor. Yes, that's... well, doesn't do a whole lot. But I might draw a Glinthawk and finish the shenanigans much quicker. In for 3. Oh, not even... where? No. Just gonna wait for the declare blocker's phase, sure. Alright, down to 8. Necrogen Sensor effectively puts my opponent at 4, so it doesn't actually kill my opponent. Well, it kills my opponent 1 turn sooner rather than 2 turns sooner. Yeah, I guess I'll play another land, why not? Leave up Slice and Twain mana. Who knows? Might be casting Slice and Twain at end of turn, and I think I will. Slice and Twain at end of turn, and then if I draw a Fangrim Marauder on my own turn, yeah, then I can do so. Alrighty, Darksteel Juggernaut, now a scary 2-2. Yeah, I mean, I'm going to be slicing in Twain this Ratchet Bomb just for the card, pretty much. Because, alright. Sure, returning Foundry. So my opponent's going to replay Foundry for not much value. It seems like got the order wrong there. Could have had a counter on Golem Foundry if that's the way you were going to go about it. And yeah, I can happily block Darksteel Juggernaut. And yeah, Ratchet Bomb won't come back. I mean, which could have been relevant. Alrighty, let's lesson 20, the Ratchet Bomb, since that's the only artifact that dies and actually does something. Well, actually, it's the only artifact that does anything. Darksteel Juggernaut is not doing anything. As I will continue to block it. And I'll make you lose 2 life now so I can F6. Boom. Alrighty. And see, there's my Fangor Marauder. Yeah, let's play out this Fangor Marauder. Because this will require my opponent to block everything. I'm going to get him to 4, and the Flyers will get him to 1, so absolutely everything will need to be blocked. And if artifacts are dying, I'm going to be gaining life. So, bash in with the lot. I'm guaranteed to gain 5 life from this Mere token, which seems like value, and it's going to trade with something. Well, I mean, I guess Acolyte could block and prevent. No, that doesn't work, because then my opponent will just die to Flyers. So yeah, this Mere is actually going to trade with something and going to gain 5 life as well. Good times. And I've still got this Arrest, because I didn't see anything worth arresting the entire game. It's rather unfortunate. So, you will have to block this Mere, whether you want to or not. And I'm going to gain 10 life off the 2 artifacts that die. Seems like value. And, yeah, sure. 1, 2. Ba-ba-dum. Don't forget to use Acolyte or you just die straight up. Yep. And lose 2 life. Alrighty, now I can F6. Boom! Alrighty. Yeah, gaining 10 life even further invalidates Darksteel Juggernaut, because even if he was big now, when I've got this much life, I don't even need to worry about it. So, yeah, GG's. That's the GG's. I mean, Phyrexian Rebirth might have turned it around, but yeah, I think my opponent's deck was quite underpowered. Let's hope for a better showing in round 2.